Fast forward, Micah, I said to you, what is your favorite Travis Pastrana clip of all time? And we've got this on tape for you.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything that holds more than that double backflip 360. I think you could watch this clip over and over and over, and you wonder if it's CGI every single time.
It's funny, Travis. I think when a lot of people think of you and who probably don't know you, just think your double backflip is the most iconic trick you've ever done, and obviously that is timeless. But the battle you had with this trick and kind of the significance for you, can you give us a bit of an insight into what this trick meant to you and the culmination of what 11 years trying to do it?
Yeah, so started doing that trick on a bicycle in 2001, landed it I think in 2017. So 16. Think about that, like as far as like trampoline in 2000, bicycle 2001. Kind of figuring it out, doing it on smaller pit bikes and trying to figure out how to do it on a mountain bike. Finally was able to, honestly, we're sitting, Dusty Weigel and I were sitting at a pub, ironically enough, over, we had a doubleheader over in France, or in, no, sorry, was it England or France? It was for the double back. Sometimes this sounds horrible, but like when you get on tour, like a lot of the venues kind of blend in because you wake up the next morning, you're already in the next stadium. So you miss the travel. Next country, next everything. And you don't, you're just in the bottom, the bowels of the stadium. And then, you might get out for a little bit to go do some interviews and kind of sleep deprived and everything. But the show on the first night, it must have been the O2 Arena. First night was absolutely packed house, O2 Arena, like it was electric. Every single person stepped up and did a world's first, did something they'd never done before. And Dusty and I were kind of the old guys, we're both kind of hurt. And then we had just done the press tour and we're tired. We started having a few drinks that night and we're like, man, when's the last time we did something cool? Dude, it's been, and we had to like, we're thinking about it. We're like, get the Rolodex out. Like, 2 years ago, I'm like, oh man. I'm like, all right, Dusty. I'm like, double backflip 360. I'm like, I know that I can do it because I've done it into the foam pit, but we kind of put it on the back burner for a while. And I said, I know you can do it because I've seen you do it in the foam pit. He's like, well, I'll land it before you'll land it. And by this point, don't get me wrong. We get done the show at 10. We sign autographs. We have the MVCs. We go to the hotel. It's 1 a.m. We're bribing the bartender to keep past. I mean, not like drunk, but just, to have your beer before you go to bed. And we talked to the track crew, was all there, Brooksy and all the guys, because they had a rare night off because we had two nights in the same spot. And Brooksy goes, hey, we'll put the big ramp up if you guys want to get there before practice. Practice at 10 a.m. So like, all right, we'll get there at 8. That's 6 hours from now. Perfect. Let's do it. So sure enough, Dusty's knocking on my door at 6 o'clock the next morning. So he doesn't like to sleep. And we go out there and I crashed on a single backflip trying to just jump it. I crashed on a double backflip trying to see what I could do. And Dusty is fixing my bike. He's like, all right, now I'll actually hit the ramp. And I went down and just dumb luck, double backflip 360 and rode out of it. I was more shocked than anybody. Dusty didn't come down that ramp for probably another hour. He sat up there and I don't know if he cried physically, but he cried inwardly. And he was like, he was a sunken man. He's like, okay, now we were the last two old guys that haven't done something cool in a while. You go do something that's never been done in my sport. Like, I hate you. But what I learned that day was that I'd rather be lucky than good. And if you add another flip to a backflip 360, it's actually easier. You need a lot more time. So we didn't know if it was possible on a motorcycle, but at that point I really started working towards this because I had crashed so many times on a backflip 360. But realizing that if it comes around like a backflip 270, you just lean back again, it should go in theory. So we get out there, not to tell a super long story long, we're filming for Action Figures 2. And it's the last day of filming. And I had always wanted to do this, but we were running behind on schedule. We hadn't got a lot of sleep because the rain, and we're with Hubert, we're working on jumps and finalizing the ramps, and we want to get the back-to-back double backflip and then the train with the double backflip, triple backflip train with bicycles and motorcycles. you know, I crashed 5 times that day. I actually started the day with an ice in my boot. So, you know, thank you, Todd Mine. Much appreciated. It was like just the endless day. It was just about to get dark. And we had the jump that Hubert, I told him, if everything goes well today, I want to try double backflip 3. And it's to like an airbag resi landing. So I was like, I'm not going to die, right? It'll be fine. But we didn't have time to set up the distance. And everything in my house always has like a kink to it. So it's not like you're doing the hardest trick you've ever done, maybe that anyone's ever done on a motorcycle. But you're going around a left and a right, and you're shifting up to third on the takeoff, and you got all this going wrong. And then there's no run out in the landing. Who needs that? Like right through the woods. So I tried it the first time, and I was convinced that I didn't knock myself out. Like I remembered all the way up to landing, and I closed my eyes for a second, and I woke up, and someone had pooped in my pants, and all my friends were just magically all around me, just real quick. It was amazing. Like a full poop. I don't know who the hell would have done that. It was anyway, so everyone's like, oh man. Like I actually like pulled the pants kind of back. I was like, dude, like it's not just a little, it was sorry, my French, this is proper shit. So what had happened was, I guess I was a little unconscious and I hit hard enough to do that. So everyone's like, all right, go back, regroup. I'm like, if I go up to the house, there is no way I'm going to change out of my riding gear and come back and do this. So I crashed 2 more times. I smashed my head. I hurt my shoulder. And I get up, and everyone's trying to talk me out of it. And Trevor Jacob, and this is a guy that he qualifies for the Olympics at #1 World Cup U.S. guy for border cross as a joke. Like, just we have some very amazingly talented, unique individuals on
the diverse for sure. And,
oh, Trevor's, and he's at the top of that list. And everyone's trying to talk me out of it. And I'm almost like, you know what? Yeah, it's not worth it. Lindsay's like, dude, okay, you're going to get, you know, like there's a certain amount that this movie's going to make. You've already doubled that budget. We have lost hundreds of thousands of dollars before the videos even come out. Like that's your maximum we could possibly take. So not only are you spending my money, our kids' money, your money, you are now potentially risking paralysis. You have poop in your pants. Quit while you're behind. No one has to know you failed. I was like, yeah, you all great points there, honey. I love you. Yeah. And she's like, and there's no money on the line. There's no, everyone's trying to talk you out of it. Like there's nothing to win here. And Trevor Jacob came up to me, matter-of-factly. He said, do you think you can do it? I said, I know I can do it. So then stop messing around and just go do it already. And I kind of looked at him. He's like, you know, you've backed out. You've spotted your landing. You've backed out here. You've uncommitted here. He's like, if you think you can do it, the only way to know is to commit 100%. He's like, no safety checks, because you come around the first backflip 3 and you want to see the landing. But if you look at the landing, you stop your momentum. He's like, it's going to take every ounce of energy that you have, every ounce of commitment. He goes, basically, you're going to have to take off and you're going to go blind the whole time. And you can see the helmet cam was just looking at the sky and nothing. And he goes, when it comes around, you'll either land on your face and you'll be unconscious or you'll ride out. Either way, you will know 100% that that trick is doable on this ramp today in these conditions, or it's not. And I landed and my feet blew off the foot pegs and I was flying into the woods at Mach 5 because I didn't want to let off the throttle because I wanted to like not fall over, touch a foot. And I hit the trees at third gear, pretty much pinned. I felt like Ryan Sipes. Oh, it was cool. And then hey, I so $10. I still had poop in my pants though, you know?
So tell me,